Rachael Gerstel, and I am a Los Angeles-based personal trainer. I am an alumni ambassador for Lululemon and head trainer of the Debbie Reynolds Scholarship Program based out of the Debbie Reynolds Studio in Los Angeles. Stoked to be a part of Dance Genius today. We're gonna have a great workout. So this was designed for different reasons. You can use this workout as an alternative to your routine of the day. So if you're short on time, this is going to give you everything that you need. So you've got a clean warm up, you're gonna be working with aerobic conditioning, anaerobic conditioning, getting that core strength. It's also ideal if you're going to be using it for just a warm up to get into your studio session with your kids, with your young adults, with your full on adults. So I designed this program so that it would be accessible to all levels. Every movement I give, there'll be an option for. So maybe if you're coming back from an injury, or you know, you just need something different to pull back, there's gonna be an option for that too. So yeah, let's just get started. Let's just do this. Neck is nice and long. Tight quads, tight glutes, tight inner thighs. From here, you're gonna tap right hand to the left shoulder, left to the right, without moving those hips. You're finding that stability. Up and down. You're here for 60 seconds. Now, if 60 seconds seems too long, then make it a little bit shorter. Maybe it's 30 seconds, maybe it's 20 second intervals with a 10 second rest. It's really yours to customize. After that minute is over, you're going to press into a down dog. So spinning the eyes and the elbows forward, chest towards your thighs. Now this is where it gets a little bit crazy. We designed a push-up sequence. So we're gonna round the upper back, we're gonna lengthen all the way through, and you're gonna drop 8 push-ups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. On the 8th one, you're gonna press right back to that down dog. Looking forward, use your arms for balance. Hold your shoulders down and back. Again, we warmed up those inner and outer thighs, so those knees should not be knocking in, should not be over rotating. Nice parallel. Now every time you stand, you're gonna press the ground away to your heels. Squeeze your glutes all the way up to the top. Open those hips, and then you're right back down. Big squeeze. So you got 16 of those. From there, we're gonna take it into a lateral lunge. We're gonna start with our feet together. You're gonna step out to the right leg, core is tight. You're gonna pull that belly in, looking straight ahead. Now you can take your arms out, you can hold them here, right on your hips, whatever feels comfortable for you. And then we're gonna add a knee drop at the top. So we're really activating that supporting leg and glute. Power up, and you're gonna come right back down. Light, and as effortless as you can make it look, right? Even if it's not effortless, it should look that way. You're gonna finish this round with palms to elbow. So we're coming back down into that plank position, and this is to really activate the triceps, shoulders, core, all that good stuff. So in that plank, now you found that stability with that shoulder tap, so here we are again. This time, it's a progression. Press up to that plank, right down. Up, up, down, down. Now the goal is to do 8 on each side. So the first 8 would be up with the right, down with the left. Second 8, up with the left, down with the left. As light as you possibly can. You don't want to hear those arms slamming down. We really want to strengthen the shoulder girdle, the elbow joint, the wrist, all that good stuff.